If these two fish are the same, then of course you get that fish back. So that's the idea. Let's do some math for fun. And today, due to popular demand, we are going to solve c to c is power is equal to I. So this is actually similar to x power is equal to 2. Well, if you haven't seen that video, be sure you go check that out. We will be utilizing the Lambert W function. So how does that work? Let me show you. Right here, let's just take the natural log on both sides. And of course, from here, we can bring the power to the front. And we see that this is just z times ln z. And this is equal to natural log of I, like that. And now you might be wondering, what is ln I? Well, you know, don't worry too much. Just worry about that later. And remember, in order for us to utilize the Lambert W function, I will just put a note right here for you guys. If these two fish are the same, then of course you get that fish back. So that's the idea. Now, I just have to somehow produce the E so that I can make things happen, huh? How can we do that? Well, if you look at this Z right here, I have the ln Z already. Let me write that in the front, ln Z, like this. I want to have base E to help me out. And when I have this e right here, in fact, I can just look at this as e raised to the ln z's power like that. How wonderful is that? Because e and ln cancel, you get that z back. And this is precisely in the form that we want. And of course, on the right-hand side, we still have ln I like this. And then from here, yes, we will be taking the Lambert W function on both sides. So W there and W here, like this and like that. On the left-hand side, we get ln z. Remember, when these two are the same, you just get that back. So you have ln z right here. On the right-hand side, you can still write down W of ln of I like this. And in the end, to get z by itself, of course, we can just do e to the power and e to the power, so they cancel. And finally, you see that z is equal to e raised to the w of ln I inside, like this, for the power. Now we just have to answer what ln I is. And let's do it on the side. What we need to do is we have to look at the complex plane. So let me draw it for you guys. Here we have the real axis, and here we have the imaginary axis. And for I is this point right here. But this is like 0 plus 1i. And you need to know two things. Here is I, and the distance from 0 to I is 1. And the other thing you have to know is the angle from here to here, which is pi over 2. So what we can do is that we can look at I, which is in the standard form. We can change that to the polar form. So I is equal to get to the polar form, you need the 1, which is the distance. And then you multiply by e raised to the I theta, which is this angle that we have at the moment. So they'll put down pi over 2, like that. And now I will just put this right here for this I, and then you will see ln and an e cancel each other out. So that's pretty much it. However, though, this is not the only angle that you can end up right here, because you can keep rotate either this way or the other way. So what you have to do is you will have to add 2n pi, where n is just an integer. So let me just tell you, n belongs to the integer. So you can go either direction. So I will technically put this right here, plus 2n pi, like that. And then this right here will be my angle, that kind of thing. Well, what is ln I then? Let me just show you ln I. Of course, now I is this, so we have ln of 1 times this is just e, and then we have the I times pi over 2 plus the 2n pi like this. And yeah, of course, this and that cancel. Let's put this down first. So we have pi over 2 plus 2n pi, and then times the I right here. Now, I just have to put this right here for ln I, and this right here is our answer. And of course, we can also use 1 from alpha to get some approximations, as you can see right here. Anyway, this right here is it.